T-Hawk is Mexico's pride, next to other characters such as El Fuerte. T-Hawk's style is based on strong hits, agility, and power. There is a lot of mystery shrouded behind this iconic Street Fighter character, the secrets and origins of the native Indian, T-Hawk. Without further ado, let me welcome you to the Street Fighterverse. T-Hawk is one of the tallest characters in the Street Fighter universe, standing around 7.7 feet high, next to Sagat, Abigail, and Hugo. He has strong arms and legs, which can attack and create great damage to any opponent. T-Hawk has his face painted in a traditional native Indian battle style. He wears a denim vest and pants, iron bracers entirely covering both forearms, thin steel armbands around his biceps, a cowboy-style brown leather belt with a buckle and metal decorative tokens. He also wears moccasin shoes, or boots, and a blue and white triangular patterned headband with a pair of white eagle feathers. One of them is red at its end tip, etched diagonally upwards from it. The accessories that T-Hawk wears in his head are a remembrance of his father, Arroyo Hawk. His father was the leader of the Thunderfoot tribe. The Thunderfoot are from Mexico. When T-Hawk was young, the Thunderfoot tribe was forced to move out of their land by the Shadaloo. Members of the Thunderfoot fought against the Shadaloo, but unfortunately lost their lives in the process, including Arroyo Hawk, who died by the hands of N. Bison. T-Hawk resides in the Monte Alban Plains near Mexico. T-Hawk wants nothing more than revenge from Bison for his despicable actions and to reclaim the land that was taken from his people. The Thunderfoot tribe had also experienced disappearances of many of their people. T-Hawk took the responsibility of finding them. One of them, his beloved Julia, became Julie, one of Bison's brainwashed assassins known as the Dolls. Julia was T-Hawk's lover, living in the same village of the Thunderfoot tribe. She was captured by Shadaloo and brainwashed to be part of the Dolls, M. Bison's assassins and bodyguard. They were completely loyal to Bison, acted and talked like robots, and they were high-ranking members in the Shadaloo. Julie is partnered with Junie, who appear as sub-bosses in Street Fighter Alpha 3 series. She is the second oldest member of the Doll, being often consulted for advice by the other members. Julie is the most rational of the Dolls, but sometimes she appears to be ruthless, possibly due to having her memory erased multiple times by the Shadaloo. T-Hawk is commonly brave, tough, selfless, noble-spirited, centered and fearless, but equally moody, cold, brutish, unemotional, and apparently unsympathetic. His lack of emotional display mostly comes from suffering and devastation inflicted by M. Bison towards the Thunderfoot tribe and their sacred homelands. Despite his externally hard exterior, T-Hawk is actually a warm-hearted, compassionate man, as evidenced in several of his artworks, where he shows unquenchable affection for native animals, who cites revenge solely on the purpose of rescuing his long-lost people and restoring his ruined homelands back to its former glory. T-Hawk is similar to Sangief in strength, but uses more calculated attacks. Even though he is a large individual, he can defeat many smaller, faster fighters with his devastating Tomahawk Buster. The move starts when T-Hawk ducks down and crosses his fist in front of his face, then rapidly stretches his arms out behind himself like wings, and jumps diagonally up, ramming his opponent in with his head and or shoulder. He also uses the Condor Dive. The move starts when T-Hawk quickly pauses in mid-air and dives diagonally in a roughly 45-degree angle towards the ground, with his arms spread backwards like wings. This move executes exclusively on the way up during a jump, thus cannot be performed while coming down. T-Hawk also uses the Mexican Typhoon technique. As T-Hawk grabs his opponent, he will catch them by the head with one hand, leap into the air, and spin them around in a circle several times like a windmill, before slamming them down into the ground for a devastating impact. Unlike most bulky warriors, he does not like to grapple, but he can when necessary. More often, however, he uses the swooping aerial attacks that are also at his disposal. T-Hawk's background in the Super Street Fighter 2 game is a real-life location. Its location is said to be inspired by the Hospicio Cabañas in Guadalajara, Mexico. It's a World Heritage Site, is one of the oldest and largest hospital complexes in the Americas. The complex was found in 1791 by the Bishop of Guadalajara in order to combine the functions of a workhouse, hospital, orphanage, and almshouse. It owes its name to Juan Ruiz de Cabañas, who was appointed to the See of Guadalajara in 1796. and engaged Manuel Tolsa, a renowned architect from Mexico City, to design the structure. Tolsa's design was based on classic examples such as Les Invalides in Paris and El Escorial near Madrid. The buildings form a rectangle, measuring 538 by 476 feet. These are single-story structures, which are 25 feet in height. The chapel is twice as high and has a dome rising to 107 feet. The complex is erected on one level, so as to facilitate the movement of the sick, the aged, and the children. We all recognize that sounding rhythm that captivates your ears as soon as we enter T-Hawks' stage. But have you ever wondered who was the producer of that legendary Western style of music? The music from T-Hawks' Hospicio Cabaña stage in Mexico was created by the legendary music producer Isao Abe. He was one of the main musicians and composers for the Street Fighter series. The first and most famous work produced by Isao Abe in Street Fighter II was the composition of the main theme for the character Sagat, including its unique time signature, as well as the original Versus melody. It is said that the name of T-Hawks' theme, Eye of the Eagle, was inspired by Survivors' 1982 hit song, Eye of the Tiger. T-Hawk, as stated before, is from Mexico. Mexico is a country in the southern portion of North America. It is bordered to the north by the United States, to the south and west by the Pacific Ocean, to the southeast by Guatemala, Belize, and the Caribbean Sea, and to the east by the Gulf of Mexico. It is home to the Aztec Empire of the Triple Alliance, Nahuatl-Altepet city-states, Mexico, Tenochtitlan, Texcoco, and Tlacopan. These three city-states ruled the area in and around the Valley of Mexico. T-Hawk is one of the most persevering Street Fighter characters in the series up to date. His relentless attitude makes him one of the most strong-willed characters in the Street Fighter series. In this episode, we have talked about T-Hawk origins, his persona, and the history behind his design and creation. So what did you like about T-Hawk Origins? Let us know in the comment section down below. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell to stay up to date on new theories and info. Thank you for watching. This was your Street Fighter host. Welcome to the Center Stage.